First of all, I think you'll notice that revenue was stable at 6.5 billion rand. HEPS was up significantly, 151%, which we're quite happy with. Of course, underlying that, most important measure for us there is trading income, up 11% to 706 million rand. And then at the bottom line, operating income up 89%, and we'll unpack that a bit later. All group funding covenants complied with, which of course our bankers are very happy with. And then I guess the most important thing is what happened to cash. Now, cash is up 852 million rand, which is very pleasing. That's up 19% from what it was this time last year. Okay, next. Oh, sorry, let me just wait for my presentation to move. Okay, so just very briefly, if we look at our strategy, now remember, this is not the detail of our strategy. I think at the top there, you're seeing the two objectives that we're moving towards, and at the bottom, the four enablers that will assist us to get to these strategic objectives. And we'll spend a bit of time on that later on, but I think that's nothing new at this stage. So let's see how we've done against those objectives. I think, first of all, if you look at the group, of course, as mentioned, all our covenants we comply to. And very importantly, the composition of our debt has improved dramatically. You'll see a bit later on to what extent we managed to improve the level of US dollar debt that's in there. Obviously, a lot lower US dollar debt, which is improving our risk profile quite dramatically. If we look at metals, Bevcan specifically, some key contracts that we managed to extend. We also got a new export contract on top of the can body contract that we already had. And then I think there's a good reason the next one is at the center of the page. And that's really, if we look at our DIF Food division, exceptional performance. This division made a very significant loss in the prior 6 months. Where in this 6 months, they actually made a trading profit. It's not yet where we wanted to be. I think there's still more to come from further the conclusion of Project Lego. But at the moment, very pleasing and a big contribution to the upside in our profits. If we move on to the plastics division, they've in the process of consolidating some of their inland plants and also rationalizing their product portfolio. Also a good improvement there, and we're quite proud of that. Our paper side, it was a lot tougher, and we'll look at that a bit now. But in Zambia, we specifically improved the situation by diversifying our customer base. We used to be reliant more on one big customer for certain products. We now managed to diversify that base, which led to some growth for that. And then, of course, the exciting one is our newly sort of concluded joint venture with Elopac. Before, we couldn't start trading. We had to get all the regulatory approvals for that. That is now in place, and we can now finally start trading. So if we look at the operational review, maybe before we get to the individual bits, I think let's just stand back and say, well, what do we as management think of this set of results? So before we look at the details, like I say, if you actually consider the trading conditions in virtually all the territories where we operate, the conditions were tough. I mean, other than Nigeria, I think Nigeria is probably the one exception where you'll see we've had very good trading conditions. In all the other territories, these were tough conditions. And keep in mind that the set of results that we currently look at had a huge impact from COVID-19, where the comparable results from the prior year, other than the last couple of days from March, didn't have any impact of COVID. And despite that, I think you'll see that we've managed to improve our results quite dramatically. So from our side, it's very pleasing. You know, the improvements did not come from the trading conditions. It actually came from the projects, the restructuring, the simplification projects that we ran within the divisions. And we're very happy with that. And therefore, once we start looking forward for the next 6 months, we're very optimistic for the simple reason that I think for the next 6 months, it's more going to be a like-for-like comparison where we will look at a period that has got a lot of impacts from COVID-19 still around, and of course, to last year where we had a terrible impact from COVID-19. But maybe back to the current 6 months under review. So if I can start with the metal side, I think that's where we've seen the big success. And as I said, most of that came from the Diff Food turnaround, up 28% trading profit. If you then look at the plastic side and paper, both are down. Okay, obviously much smaller profit contributors. So plastic down 11%, paper down 39%, and we'll unpack it just now. But most of that actually came from outside of South Africa, mostly in the rest of Africa, where trading conditions were really hugely impacted by COVID-19. At a very high level, in conclusion, I think we're saying the recovery is on track. If you look at the set of results, as I mentioned, the improvement did not come from easier trading conditions. In fact, they were worse than before, other than Nigeria. So very happy overall that we managed to claw back our profitability, not as like I say, from the underlying conditions, but from the operations themselves through improved cost structures, lower fixed cost, and improved efficiencies. So overall, I think we've enhanced our position to compete. Through those, we've also secured some of the contracts going into the future to make sure that we can stabilize our market share for Bevcan specifically in South Africa. I've mentioned the reduced cost base. And of course, we will continue to simplify not only our portfolio, but also the product range. So we mentioned that we've got two assets that we've already disclosed as operations held for sale. The first one is our diversified operation in Mabeni. And we hope to have some news about that coming soon. And the other one is our tubes business that we're also looking at disposing. So overall, I think we're not there yet, but we certainly optimized our footprint. I think there's more work to be done, as I mentioned. But then the big one, of course, is how do we create capacity for future growth? So when we look at our strategy, when we say we want to reduce risk, it's not only about making sure that we can sort of keep the banks happy. We have to keep our shareholders happy as well. So we are reevaluating our capital structure. We need to make sure that we are fit for growth. If you look specifically at the CapEx slides that Glenn put forward, you'll notice that obviously we managed to reduce the CapEx spend significantly, with most of it over the last year being spent on the replacement side. Very little on the expansion side. So, of course, once we have our debt under control again, it's all about looking to the future. How do we create the enabling environment to make sure that we can grow into the future?